Hello. A very warm welcome to dear students. Very good morning to all of you. Maybe all of you are very eager to check the meeting with IAS officer. Since he's an IAS officer, he's right now unavailable. So please bear with us. We'll have his session later. So this is Dr. T.P. Surekar, Professor and Dean of Academic Affairs, will be communicating for this session based on rules and regulations of academics. Am I audible to all of you? Yes, to begin with, we have short titles and definitions connected with autonomous. Since ours is the first batch, 2021, so congratulations to all of you for joining this autonomous institution. So you need to know some of the rules and regulations connected with this autonomous. The regulations are framed based on VTU, that is Vishveshwaraya Technological University guidelines for the implementation of autonomy that is connected with academic. So we start with this approval from the governing body on recommendation of the Academic Council of VVCE. So we have a GB, very beginning, the body starts with the governing body on recommendations with the Academic Council. These regulations shall govern all the students seeking admissions to undergraduate program, BE, the postgraduate programs, MTech and MBA, which is offered by Vidyavardhaka College of Engineering under autonomous scheme from this academic year 2021. Academic autonomy means freedom granted by the university to the college in all aspects of conducting its academic programs for promoting academic excellence. So here you need to know some of the definitions. Regular students means students who are admitted to the first year of their respective program. Program is nothing but the branch. Lateral entry means students who are admitted to the third semester of the respective program. Course means one of the subject, either theory or practical, identified by its title and code number, which comprises a program of study. Like, for example, I'll say the year 20 is the first beginning, 20. MA stands for mathematics, that is a subject code, and the 11 indicates it's the first semester with first course. So this is a kind of a course code will be indicated in your first semester subject. So coming to the program duration and total credits. So we have totally 175 credits for the complete course of BE degree. So we need to have bachelor of degree with a minimum 4 years you need to complete and maximum of 8 years. So with the total number of credits to award, a degree is 175. For the lateral entry students, then a total number of credits will be 135. And for MBA, it is 100 credits, and MTech, it is 88 credits. So this is the total number of credits where the students have to earn the total credits to be awarded as their respective degrees. Coming to academic year, so in a semester, in an academic year, we have totally three semesters. The first semester will be an odd semester, what we are commencing now. So this is the registration of the courses commences here 1 week before the commencement of the semester. So we have already started with this SIP program. So immediately the students, when you come on to the classes, your registration will be done in your respective departments. So the complete coursework will be meant for 16 weeks. After 16 weeks of completion of the course, preparation for exams will be 1 week. And 1 week, the exams will be taken care of. and declarations of results will be done for another 1 week. So the total odd semester is meant for 19 weeks. This is first odd semester. After this, you will have 3 weeks of vacation. And the next is even semester, where you will have the commencement of the semester once again with for 16 weeks and additional of 3 weeks meant for preparation and examinations and results. Again, another 19 weeks for even semester. Between this odd and even semester, after this, you will have one supplementary semester for the announcement of results, that immediately you will have total 8 weeks where the students who have failed in any of these courses in odd or even semester or who have dropped the courses, they will be given an additional classes, which is a fast track. It is also called as fast track, which we declare it as supplementary semester, where the classes will be undertaken for 7 weeks and 1 week for examination, and totally for 8 weeks, it will be conducted as supplementary semester or fast track semester. Again, after this, you will have vacation of 3 weeks. But for time being, we may not have vacation for this semester as we are starting late. So anyway, it will be intimated in advance. Coming to the credit allocation, a typical structure of the course and credit allocation for all categories is as shown. One is 1 hour lecture per week per semester will be defined as 1 credit. Please note this. It is defined as lecture L. 1 hour lecture per week per semester is 1 credit. And the second one is 2 hours tutorial per week per semester will be defined as also 1 credit, and it is identified as T. And the third one is 2 hours practical or lab or drawing per week per semester is equal to 1 credit, that is P. So these three are very important, represented as LTP. 1 hour lecture, 1 credit, 2 hours tutorial as 1 credit, and 2 hours practical as 1 credit. Coming to the categories of courses for BE, we'll have 8 different groups of categories of courses. The very first is the basic sciences, which includes the courses like mathematics, physics, and chemistry. And as per AICTE, whatever the courses we have framed here is based on AICTE model curriculum and also the frames to be taken from VTU. So AICTE suggests it should have 25 credits, but when it comes to VTU, it is 24. And as we are autonomous, we have allotted this basic science credit as 26. So the next is engineering sciences, which includes the courses like drawing, workshops, materials, so forth. So it will be usually considered in first year, where AICTE suggests 24 credits and VTU gives us 18 credits. And as a whole, credit allocation is 20. The third course is professional course, which will be usually covered in a regular courses of your respective disciplines. That is, when you come to a branch, you will have a professional course. So this course is AICTE suggests 48, VTU suggests 85, and we have allocation of 83. So this is where you will be learning all fundamental courses in all the semesters starting from third. So the fourth course is about humanities and social sciences. This includes courses like CIP, that is Constitution of India and Professional Ethics, Environmental Studies, and also courses like Communicative English and Kannada. So this AICTE suggests to have 12 credits and VTU has given 6, and we have in between of 9 credits. Coming to professional electives, it is based on your interest. You can choose your verticals of electives, professional electives. AICTE is 18 and VTU is 12. And come to credit allocation of BBC, it is 12. The next is open electives. The AICTE suggests 18, VTU as 6 and we have credit allocation of 6. This elective will be offered from other disciplines, that is other branches other than your parental branch. So where you have to, if you're interested in software, you can take up some software courses, or if you're interested in some other courses, it will be offered by other programs, or you can say branches, and you have been given an option to select any of the course, whichever is your interest, and you can suggest the, you can take up the elective courses. Coming to the last one, it's a project or internship identified as PRI. So as per ACT, it is 15 and VTU is 24 and credit allocation from our side, it is 19. So coming to this, the total credits of BBC is 175. Coming to the PG courses, categories of courses for PG, one is we have MTech course, the other one is MBA course. In MTech course also we, one is a professional core declared as hardcore, professional elective as softcore, and project internship or fieldwork as softcore once again. So the credit distribution for this professional is 42, elective is 20, and internship is 26. So totally it is 88 credits. Coming to MBA, the total credit it will be 100. And once again, it is split into three different courses. Hardcore, which is professional core, as 55 credits. Professional electives as softcore, 33. Summer internship projects as 12. So outbound training or value-added courses will also be there along with this, which are declared as mandatory courses. Coming to permissible load, during a mainstream of any program shall be within the limits of a minimum of 16 credits and a maximum of 28 credits. In any case, the number of credits shall not be less than 16 after withdrawal or dropping of course in that semester. The total number of credits is 175, have to be earned by a student to obtain a BE degree, and lateral entry students, or diploma we call it, they have to earn 135 credits. So how to register for these courses? Students should register for all the courses as per the scheme of study in each of the main semesters, whether it is an odd or even semester. Registration to courses shall be done with the respective faculty advisor or what you have been declared as a mentors, who are also called as proctors, by appearing in person during the date specified in the academic calendar. Students who have dropped or withdrawn from a course or obtained F grade in a course in any semester should repeat those courses in their entirety by re-registering in supplementary semester or as when the courses are offered. Students who have dropped or withdrawn from a course or obtained F grade in a course in any semester should repeat those courses in their entirety by re-registering in supplementary semester or when it is offered. If a student has dropped or withdrawn from an elective course or obtained F grade in an elective course, then the students shall have an option of re-registering the same elective course if it is offered, or re-register for any other equivalent elective course. If a student obtains F grade in project or internship, then the student has to take up a new project or internship topic. Registration in absentia of a student, but through the authorized representative, will be allowed only in exceptional cases at the direction of principal after the recommendation of the Department Academic Affairs, which also be noted through Dean Academic Affairs. Coming to the dropping of course, a A student with poor performance in CIE, CIE stands for Continuous Internal Evaluation, can drop the identified course unadvised from the faculty advisor after his or her review of student's performance in CIE. Such students who want to drop a course shall do so towards the middle of the semester within the specified date mentioned in the academic calendar by applying in the prescribed format through the course instructor, faculty advisor, and also the HOD to the Dean of Academic Affairs to be taken as a permission. And then the student is not permitted to drop any course after the specified date. The courses dropped shall not be mentioned in the grade card. Dean of Academic Affairs will forward the consolidated list of students who have dropped the courses to the Office of COE. COE is nothing but Controller of Examination. A student is permitted to drop more than one course in a semester. However, the number of credits in that semester cannot fall below 16 after dropping. A student is not allowed to, that is, laboratory, skill development, career electives, major project, and internship courses. A student is not allowed to drop the same course more than once. Dropping of course is not permitted in supplementary semester. The student should have maintained the minimum attendance, that it should be equal to or greater than 85% in the course as on the date of dropping of course. If the dropped course is a core course, the student has to re-register for the same course in the supplementary semester, or else if the course is dropped as an elective, then the student has the option to re-register for the same elective or equivalent elective when offered in the supplementary semester or when offered in the subsequent semesters. A student with poor performance in CIE can withdraw from the identified course on advice from the faculty advisor after his or her review of student's performance in CIE. Student who is permitted to withdraw from a course will be temporarily awarded W grade in that course with the mention of it in the grade card. Such students will have to re-register to the withdrawn course in the supplementary semester after paying the prescribed fees. Dean will forward the consolidated list of students who have withdrawn from the courses to the Office of COE, recommending for the award of W grade. W grade shall be converted to one of the other letter grades as S to F after the completion of the withdrawn course in supplementary semester. Student is permitted to withdraw from more than one course in a semester. However, the number of credits in that semester cannot fall below 16 after withdrawal. A student is not allowed to withdraw from experiential learning and activity-based courses. A student is not allowed to withdraw from same course more than once. Withdrawal from course is not permitted in supplementary semester. Whether it is a dropped or a withdrawal, the courses, the conditions remains to be the same. The student should have maintained the minimum attendance of 85% in the course as on the date of withdrawing the course. Coming to the attendance requirement, a student must obtain a minimum attendance of 85% in each course to appear for the semester and examination. Students who have attendance between 75% and less than 85% may get condonation of attendance by the principal only on valid grounds such as hospitalization, participation in university and intercollegiate sports, cultural activities and participation in seminar, workshop and paper presentation with prior permission. Students must submit the request for condonation of attendance in the prescribed format with the supporting documents through Dean Academic Affairs, duly recommended by the head of the department at least 1 week before the commencement of examination, failing which condonation of attendance will not be considered. Students having less than 75% are not eligible for condonation of attendance on any ground. If a candidate fails to satisfy the minimum attendance requirement in any of the course, then they will be declared as fail. So coming to the change of branch. Change of branch shall be permitted in accordance with the provisions laid down by the University and Academic Council of ABC. Change of branch shall be permitted if the strength in any branch is not falling below 75% of the admissions at first year level in the respective branch or branches. Change of branch can be made only against the clear vacancy in the respective branch, where it stands as or abbreviated as V is given by I minus REG plus REP, where I stands for sanctioned intake for the specific branch prescribed by the ACT for the previous academic session when the students were admitted at first semester level. REG indicates the number of regular students who become eligible to be promoted to Hello, can you hear me? Is it fine? Can you hear me, students? Because I could see no video and no sound. Hello? Hello? Yes, fine. Thank you. Hello? Yes, fine. So I'm repeating the backslide. Eligibility to apply based on this change of branch. Okay. Change of branch shall be permitted only in accordance with the provisions laid down by the university and academic council. And it shall be permitted if the strength in any branch is not less than 75% of the admissions at first year in the respective branch. Change of branch can be made only against a clear vacancy in the branch, where V is equal to I minus REG plus REP, where I stands for sanctioned intake for the branch prescribed by the ACT for the previous academic sessions when the students were admitted at first semester level. And REG is the regular students, and REP is the students who got permitted to the next year after they have lost the course. So the students who get admitted into third semester of either REG or REP to be added, and they need to be subtracted from the sanctioned intake. And only if the vacancy is more than, if it's not falling 75%, only for such seats, the change of branch will be provided. And one more thing, the change of branch shall be strictly in the order of merit of the applicants. For that purpose, CGPA will be considered. Branch change cannot be reverted or changed once again once when you take a change of branch. So coming to how you're going to apply, only those students who are eligible for third semester as per vertical progression regulations shall be eligible to apply for change of branch. SNQ category of students are not eligible for change of branch as procedure for applying is the university or college will invite applications for change of branch for the academic year. The students shall apply to the university or college with a non-refundable fee as fixed and notified by the college. No request would be entertained after the last date of notification. Applying for change of branch does not guarantee the approval for change of branch. So finally, coming to the generation of merit list, on the basis of applications received, college will prepare the merit list as detailed below. Students who have passed in all the subjects shall be placed above in the merit list as per CGPA. I told earlier, CGPA stands for Cumulative Grade Point Average. Students who have failed in few subjects but eligible to seek admissions to third semester as per vertical progression shall be placed below as per the number of courses failed and as per CGPA. Foreign students admitted under any quota and students admitted under GOE and PIO, etc. will be placed last in the merit list as per the section. Ties in case shall be resolved by considering the percentage obtained at 10 plus 2 level by the applicants. Merit list does not depend on the re-evaluation process. So you will have an answer and question session, which you will be answering, where you'll be getting the forms. And also I have placed the questions. Yes, I've got one question. What is credits? Very beginning, I've told you the credit is nothing but based on the lectures what we give in theory, practicals and tutorials. So once when we give a theory lecture, it is declared as one credit that I've explained in my earlier slide, but I'm repeating you once again. Credit is nothing but based on lectures, which is what we give it in a regular class, and tutorials, like where we help you out to solve the problems, and the labs where you'll be conducting the laboratory experiments using hands-on. So for tutorial and practical, it is 2 hours meant for one credit. But when we give a lecture, it is one credit is equal to 1 hour. Is it okay? Saturday is not a holiday. Somebody is asking a question. It is a working day and it is a half day. Please, you can post your questions. Sunday will give a holiday, but if the classes portions are not completed as per this pandemic situation, we might engage one or two Sundays. So bear it with us, okay? But regular weeks, you'll have holiday on Sunday. The college timings, it starts in the morning for our first few sections. You might have classes starting from 7:30, but our regular timings is from 8:30 till evening 5 o'clock. I think the fees, all of you have paid already, those who have got admitted. So the fee structure will remain the same as per this year, but every year it will be changing. After changing the course also, the fees remains to be the same, but for change of course, you have to apply some fee, what has been mentioned or what has been notified. Yes, somebody is asking, what is CGPA? C stands for cumulative, G stands for grade, P stands for point, average, A. So it is every semester after the completion of all the exams, you will be declared a result where you will be given with the grading system because you are in a grading category called as. The question is about CGPA, right? For each semester, you will be given a semester grade point average that is called as SGPA, semester grade point average. That is in first semester and second, each semester you'll be specified with semester grade point average. But when you're been asking for a change of branch, both the semester marks will be clubbed together and where you will be defined as cumulative grade point average. So CGPA stands for cumulative grade point average. For every academic year, you'll be getting that CGPA. No, as somebody is asking, is college uniform there? No, we don't have uniform. You want to have uniform? So you will have regularly your morning classes from starting from 8:30 till 1 o'clock. And there may be some classes 1 or 2 days in a week at 7:30. Adults regular classes will be at 8:30. And in the afternoons, you'll be having your regular labs. Or we have introduced 2 new courses called experiential learning courses called as the engineering exploration lab and also one more as social innovation. So which you will be knowing about it once the semester commences. Yes. How many internals per semester? It will be intimated through controller of examination, but I'll let you know it is details will be given through the controller of examination about the internals as well as the examinations. College timings are specified. It is from 8:30. Yes. And you're asking when will be the offline classes. So we are also eagerly waiting to see you all on the campus. So most probably by another couple of before the completion of this SIP program, we will let you know the classes will be maybe from offline from 4th of January 2021. Yes, we have sports facilities in our campus. So once when you come to campus, you will be knowing about all the sports facilities. And of course, there will be one session showing in there in your SIP, what are the facilities are available in our campus for sports. That will be shown you through video. Of course, after every class hours in the evening, you can have your sports period, but there is no sports period as per the in our regular schedule, but you can have your regular schedule after regular evening classes. So afternoons, you may have one or two classes, but usually it will be your lab classes, laboratories. So I think yesterday also somebody was asking about the bus facilities. So we have two bus specifically meant for students, but as your seniors have told that they don't require bus facility, we have stopped. But for time being, we'll be sending the buses by the nearby places, by other local buses. You can get into VVC buses from the suburban bus stand or nearby stops on the way to VVC. So two buses will be made available from the suburban bus stand. Of course, you have activities connected with NCC, NSS, and Red Cross. What books you mean to say? I could see there was a question called, what about books? You mean to say it is a textbooks or notebooks? Library, 12, from morning 8 till evening 8, as well as the reference section. So you can borrow the books in the library, and or else you can, during your free time, you can go to reference section and you can read the books in the reference section also. Yes, college will provide you the textbooks based on lending, so which you have to return back based on the specified timings or the 2 weeks or so. Yes, any other questions? Yes, you will have your labs after first week of theory classes, because we need to introduce you about the theory concepts. So first week, you'll have all your theory concepts. And then from second week onwards, you'll have your regular labs. Of course, it will be intimated once when you come for your regular classes. Minimum. So to have your degree award, once when you graduate out from the college, starting from first year till the final year is 4 years, where you have to have 175 credits for the degree award. And there are some mandatory courses which you need to pass in that, but it will not be having grading for that. But still you have to clear those mandatory courses. So credits plays a very important role, because it's a choice-based credit scheme, right? So you have been given a choice to select the subjects or courses based on your interest. Hence, it is called choice-based credit system. Hence, each credits, whatever we specified for a courses in our regular syllabus, is declared as a credit. So those are the credits which have to be earned in each semester. So the minimum credit 28 in each semester. Notebooks or sheets, whatever you can keep as you require, because you are entering into a professional college. We don't insist on that, but you need to maintain material for that to write in your regular class, because you have crossed all the days of your schools. Yes, somebody is asking for a laptop. Will there be a provision of laptops in the college? Of course, if there is a very much needed, as you borrow the books from the library, we also provide the laptops in the library where you can borrow it, use it, and return back the laptops to the library. So yeah, there will be three tests and many more things are there that will be intimated through COE, Controller of Examination, who will be engaging in the later session of today itself. You'll come to know about all the other programs connected with your CIE, that is Continuous Internal Evaluation. Mobile phones, you have to keep it in off mode in the class, and only if the course instructor specifies that they are giving you a kind of a task to use your cell phone, under such situation you can use your cell phones. You will be knowing about the question paper setting through COE. Yes, thank you all. Have a good day.
Next session
will be
from 11. Sorry, 10.
10 o'clock. Please join the link at 10 o'clock.